So in our last video, we made a presets for Instagram feed video and Instagram stories. So I'm gonna get into Instagram stories right over here. We're gonna press OK. So our project folder is here now with our sequence in here. Our timeline is now set as Instagram stories because that is the preset that we've used. And we are also in the preview window. Now we can see our vertical content black box over here. So I'm gonna pull in some clips and I'm gonna show you guys how to exactly adjust your horizontal clips into making a vertical video. Okay, so now I've imported two files, one vertical content and one horizontal content. So right now I'm gonna bring in the horizontal content over here, and this is just, we're gonna key point over here. You're gonna get this alert when you're doing importing your from your project folder into your timeline. You are going to get an alert saying the sequence settings, do you want to change them? No, we're going to keep the existing settings because you don't want to change how it actually looks. Okay, so right here, as you can see, our vertical content has black bars now, because our horizontal content, if we double click on our actual content, it leads on the outsides of the view. So what we can do is we can rotate it. Let's just go through here. It's going to be much easier. If we go in through rotate and we do 90 degrees, and I've seen this a couple times. People make it so you switch your phone to a horizontal state instead of a vertical state, but Instagram stories and all the other stories on story platforms are actually vertical. So you want to keep it as native as you can to the app's intended viewing type. So we are going to actually change that to back to zero. And what you want to do is actually you want to hold shift and you want to stretch out that video until there's no more black bars. And to make it look cool, we are going to actually unlink this so we don't have the audio clip. And we are going to actually speed duration. We're going to make this last for, let's say, 30 seconds. So now we have a 30-second time lapse. In this time lapse, we can go into color over here on the top, and we can just add a LUT over here, depending on what we want to do. Or we can just do basic correction. We can add it to be a warmer tone video, add some pink in there, bump down the exposure, up the contrast, highlight down, or maybe we can do highlight up, and then we can bring the shadows down. The whites down, maybe highlights just a little more down, and then we can go to curves, add a little basic S curve to it, and maybe we can add some. Okay, so what I was actually doing before Premiere Pro decided to crash, we're gonna go back into the color, and we're gonna go into color wheels, and we're gonna add just a little bit of blue into our shadows, and our orange into the midtones. And or orange into the highlights, add a little more blue. Now that we are done color grading and our time lapse here is done, we can go up to over here to export, go to media, or we can just do Control M. Okay, now that we are in the export settings, you can adjust the output name right now and where it actually is going to be getting stored, and change the preset over here, or your format, whatever you need to change before you upload it onto Snapchat, Instagram, but in our case we're doing Instagram, you just press Q or export and it will export it over here in the view.